The sturgeon are coming. The sturgeon are coming. Arriving in style on a giant tractor-trailer flatbed, the 110 Atlantic sturgeon swimming around in these large tanks came all the way from Pennsylvania. They're being released into the Hudson River as part of New York's ongoing effort to restore the once-threatened species to the area. Sometimes referred to as Albany beef, Atlantic sturgeon could at one time be seen on many dinner plates in New York's capital region. The giant fish are also popular among those with more elite palates.
Sturgeon is a fish that is very sought after for its caviar. It can have thousands of eggs. The eggs are salted in a brine and then turned into caviar. And that's a very expensive gourmet product. Because of this, sturgeon around the world have been overfished, and the sturgeon stocks are collapsing.
In direct response to the decreasing number of sturgeon along the U.S. East Coast, a moratorium was placed on fishing for sturgeon in 1998. But experts now say the rare species can return. It all relates to restoring the versatile Hudson River to its full potential as a healthy natural resource.
What we're trying to do in the biggest sense is restore the habitat for any number of species and really restore a habitat for human species who have been disassociated from the river as well. If you get to carry a sturgeon into the Hudson River, you get to go out on a kayak, all sorts of things that really restore people to a river that was really, for centuries, a central part of the psyche of New Yorkers and of everyone.
Many features distinguish the Atlantic sturgeon from more well-known members of the bony fish family, such as trout and bass. They are the largest member of the sturgeon family. They migrate from saltwater to spawn in freshwater, and boy, are they tough.
Sturgeon have no internal skeleton. All their armor is on the outside, so they're kind of unique in that respect.
They're an amazing animal. They're stronger than you can imagine. They are just feel like pure muscle. They have to be strong. You imagine they're going to survive in this river and in the Atlantic Ocean for decades. You got to be strong, and they are.
That's just one of two. There's another one that's inside.
10 of these immature sturgeon are sonic tagged in order to monitor their behavior and movement in the Hudson and to provide information about both wild and hatchery-raised Atlantic sturgeon.
Basically, the sonar is a way to determine the fish's movements. And that allows the state of New York, who's going to be tracking these fish, to go out periodically and locate individual fish and document where the fish has been over the last number of days. And this will tell us a lot about the behavior of the fish, and it might lead us to other groups of wild sturgeon we didn't know about.
Based on the results, the information could be used to protect critical habitats and to determine which river system the hatchery-raised fish will ultimately return to for spawning.
Atlantic sturgeon live for decades, and so where they travel and what they do with all that time and what's important to them in terms of habitat is something that we know some about, but we need to know a lot more about.
For more stories about sturgeon and other fish and wildlife of the Hudson, check out the free Hudson River Almanac, emailed weekly by the Department of Environmental Conservation's Hudson River Estuary Program. To subscribe, send an email to the address listed and write eAlmanac in the subject line.